Hi, gang. I'm glad you're all here with me. Thank you very much for joining me. I'm going to talk about this magnitude 2.9 earthquake that occurred in the St. Lawrence River near St. Pacôme, Canada. It actually happened within the impact crater of the Charlevoix crater, an asteroid that hit Earth millions of years ago that wasn't discovered until 1965 because of the impact shatter cones that were visible in this area. Scientists right now believe it was a stony asteroid about a mile and a half wide. There were faults in this area that they believe was reactivated because of this asteroid impact. Here on pass.net, they have two different images that I thought were really good showing the impact crater. This image evidently is from 2000. And then this one is an aerial radar. Everything within 300 miles was wiped out. There is the St. Lawrence fault system that runs through here that was reactivated when that occurred. Let me bring it out a little bit so you can see in relationship where it is. Here we got the United States, we got Maine, Michigan, etc. Here is some example of shattered cones from such an event as the asteroid. It inspired me to go to eBay, and I actually bought one of these. Yeah, they are very interesting. Shattered cones are a rare geological feature that are only known to form in the bedrock beneath meteorite impact craters or underground nuclear explosions. They are evident that the rock had been subjected to a shock with pressure. Some of these impact cones are very large. Hard to believe that this type of geological structure could exist for so long, and they did not even realize what they were. Here's another image of all the earthquakes that they've had, and they don't really understand why most of the earthquakes are on this side, on the probably southeastern side of the impact crater. They really don't know why they are occurring in that location. Here's another image of all the earthquakes. I'm not sure the date on this paper, but it shows the different faults. Rift fault, which would be this one right here, it looks like. And another suspected rift fault. So I thought I would look up about what would happen if another asteroid, a mile and a half across, a stony asteroid, hit the Earth. What would be the effects? One of the replies was that on land, it would wipe out an area of about 300 miles in diameter. But the real damage would come from the Earth's crust that would be flung miles into the atmosphere and cause a permanent night for months or even years. The country impacted would be effectively obliterated. If it was an ocean impact, it would cause a tsunami in all directions, about 300 feet high, which would travel around the world more than once. You know, there is images or data out there that shows a tsunami did at one time go around the entire world. And that I found that information when I was doing some research about Noah's flood. In fact, this author says the same thing. If you believe in the Bible, this is a Noah-like flood event. If it landed in the Mediterranean, it would effectively empty the entire sea. A mid-Atlantic or mid-Pacific impact would flatten every surrounding country and drown everyone who lived within a mile or more of the ocean. New York, Boston, Washington, Miami, Lisbon, the Bahamas, all the Caribbean islands would be wiped clean. Or Vancouver, Seattle, San Francisco, Los Angeles, Tokyo, Hong Kong, Singapore, etc. All the Pacific islands would be obliterated. Hope it doesn't happen anytime soon. So what kind of asteroids are coming by us this year? Here we have a list. The last one to come by was on the 18th of January There's going to be one in March on the 13th. Maybe on April 5th, another one April 28th. And they got one that is going to be very close, May 15th. Another one on May 27th, September 1st, October 4th, November 25th, December 25th and December 27th. This one they got marked in red and says impact. On February 5th, it was observed of this year that the 2009 observations were remeasured, greatly reducing the odds of impact. And it's estimated to be 10 meters in diameter, which would make it smaller than the Chelyabinsk meteor. But then they only had a very short observation of the arch. They could only watch it for one to two days, since it had been observed first, I guess, in 2009. The odds of an impact are still 26,000 times less than the background hazard level for an asteroid of this size. So that one is about 33 feet across, not a mile and a half like the one that created the Charlevoix crater. And yeah, all the earthquakes that occurred afterwards. So, you can get an idea how one thing leads me into another and another. Yeah, and I learn new things. So, what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.